Last but not least, paper six of our session today is called Accuracy and Diversity in Cross-Domain Recommendation for Cold Start Users with Positive-Only Feedback. And Paolo Tomeo is going to present it to us. Thanks. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Paolo Tomeo, PhD student from the Polytechnic University of Bari. I'm presenting a joint work with Ignacio Fernández-Tobías and Iván Cantador from the Autonomous University of Madrid, and my advisor Tomeo di Noia and Eugenio di Sciascio from the Polytechnic University of Bari. I guess you already know what user cold start problem means. In this work, we also considered the extreme cold start situation, namely when there is no information at all about some users. A possible solution to face the lack of information in the target domain is to use information in a related auxiliary domain. And a simple way to combine different domains is to horizontally concatenate the corresponding user matrices, as shown in this slide. As research questions, we ask how beneficial it is to use cross-domain information for cold start users in the positive only feedback scenario. And we consider the same question in terms of diversity, since we know that diversity is an important key factor, quality factor for the user experience. And finally, we carry out a particular analysis. We evaluated the impact of the size and diversity in the source user profile on the target recommendation quality. In order to evaluate the different methods in the positive only feedback scenario, we collected Facebook likes using the Facebook Graph API, and then we mapped the such items to the corresponding DBPDA entities using Sparkle queries, name, and the type of the items. The DBPDA is useful during the evaluation to compute the diversity, the content-based diversity. Overall, the dataset contains 5 million likes in the music domain and 800,000, in the 5 million in the music domain and 800,000 in the movie domain. For evaluating the accuracy, we used the mean reciprocal rank. For the individual diversity, interlist diversity at 10 and binomial diversity at 10. And then in order to compute the profile diversity degree, we use again the interlist diversity. As evaluation setting, we use a particular strategy proposed by Claver and Constant in RecSys 2014. We splitted the users in five folds randomly, and then for each test fold, we split the likes for each test user in a training set with composed by 10 likes, the validation set by 5, and with the remaining likes, we construct the test set. And this strategy allows us to simulate different user profile size from 0 to 10 likes in this work, using the same test set for each test user in the different configurations in order to avoid possible bias in the evaluation. As a recommendation algorithms, we considered six state-of-the-art methods, the popularity-based method as baseline, then user-based and net-based nearest neighbors methods, an implicit matrix factorization method, a two graph-based methods, a track and path rank. The last two are the only hybrid, and they can use also content-based information in form of graph, in this case extracted by DBpedia. And the other methods are only collaborative filtering. So firstly, we compared the results of these methods using a single domain versus cross-domain information. In the paper, there is a table with all the experimental results. This slide shows only a very summarized table where the green up arrows indicate improvements when cross-domain information is used for the corresponding method. As we can see, there is no overall winner, And as we can see, not all the methods can benefit from the use of cross-domain information, and some of them can be even penalized. In particular, it's worth to note that diversity always is penalized in the movie domain when music domain is used as source domain. Instead, in the music domain, when we use also movie information to recommend a music, music page, diversity is almost always was always improved. So looking for the more accurate algorithm and also for the more more diverse, because in this case we can see that there is no overall winner, but the choice of the method depends on the domain and on the number of the information available for of the user. Finally, we evaluated the correlation between the source profile size and the recommendation quality. And as we can see in these charts, there is a directly proportional relationship between these two variables. Conversely, for diversity, it turns out that more diversified source profile leads to worse recommendation, in particular in the movie domain, when music domain is the source domain. So as conclusion, we can see that cross-domain recommendation is useful to improve accuracy, but not always diversity. And the choice of the method depends on the domain and the amount of information available. And finally, it turns out that accuracy increase with the size of source profile, but conversely, it can deteriorate with the diversity. And as future work, we are planning to investigate which characteristic in the dataset can explain the difference we have seen in the results, and also to extend the analysis to more domain and also sophisticated methods such as specific cross-domain methods. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Have we any questions for our last speaker?
Hi. Sorry. Hi.
I don't see you, sorry.
Hi.
Oh, yes.
Wondering, could you explain a bit more why do you think that adding one type of information into the other increases diversity and not the other way around? It seems you might just be introducing noise into your algorithms or something like that.
Do you mean that the diversity in the recommendation called?
Yeah, if you go back to your slides where you have the arrows.
This one.
On the left one, diversity always goes down. And on the right one, diversity almost always goes up. So when, could you explain why do you think that's the case?
We are planning to investigate to understand this the reason, but maybe in this case we think that music domain in the music domain, especially in this data set, maybe there is more information and also more noise, so it could explain the worse diversity in the movie domain.
Do these results indicate that you're better to use movie information if you want to recommend music, if you're increasing both accuracy and diversity?
It seems so, that in music domain, using mode domain is more useful with respect to the converse situation.
And I presume that this would depend a lot on what domains you're crossing as well. Maybe there's some sort of similarity between movie and music tastes, but not so much between other domains.
Yeah, maybe the relationship between the domains are not symmetric.
Any more questions?
Hi. Very nice talk. So I have a comment in actually continuing other comments. So I can see that the size of these two datasets, like from the music and movies domain, is very different. Could it be that one of them is dominating the other one, or introducing any kind of bias?
Yeah, it could be, yes. And also maybe this could explain the difference also in this case, because in this when there is if there is much diversity in the user profile in the music domain, movie recommendation are worse.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And thank you, everybody, for your participation.